Hello, everybody! Yeah! I love it, man. I love it. So good to be back. So good to be back. Listen, I've been learning a lot about American culture by watching American movies. And I've noticed every time when America makes a movie about Africa, it doesn't make sense to Africans. Yeah, I was watching The Lion King the other day. I was like, why do these lions have American accents? And they're like, in Africa? And here's the messed up part. The only animal they gave an accent was the monkey. What? Yeah, and it was Caribbean. What is this? What kind of Africa is this, you know? But I'll give them this though. The only accent that made sense to me as an African was Scar's accent, because he was British and he wanted land. I was like, ha-ha! That sounds very familiar! We've been there before! Oh my God, man, I love America. I'm realizing that I wish I had the life of your dogs in America. Oh my God! If African dogs find out how your dogs are living, yeah, you're going to have an immigration problem very soon, I'm telling you. Dogs will be coming to America on a canoe. It's crazy. The other day I was just taking a walk, enjoying my day. Then I saw a dog in a stroller. Yeah, it was just chilling right there, enjoying its life. Look at me like I was just a peasant for just walking. It's like rough. Oh, that's rough. Rough. And the lady was like, so this is my dog. His name is Mozzarella. He's like a rescue. But I like to think he rescued me. He's like 90% Australian Shepherd. Do you have a dog? I was like, yeah. I have a dog in Zimbabwe. What breed is it? I was like, I think mine is just brown. Yeah, I think that's the name of the breed, brown dog. And then she's like, can I see a photo? Can I see a photo of your dog? I don't have a photo of my dog. Because my dog is an employee. Yeah, it works for me, it hunts for us, it protects us, security. Do you think Simon Cowell has pictures of his employees on his phone? Do you? Do you? Show us your phone. Do you think he's out there chilling with his friends? He pulls out his phone and says, like, guys, look at this. This is how we. Oh my God. Look at him. He's a rescue. Oh my God, he's like 100% Canadian, you know? Yeah, we just got him neutered recently. Oh my God!
Thank you very much. My name is Len Mojumasi.
Appreciate you.
My golden buzzer, Len Mojumasi. Yes, Howie.
You know what?
Employee number one.
This was epic, and it's epic because you put in the work. We see you at the Ice House, you've got to write, you work it, and it is seamless. It seems natural. It seems like you're just coming up with it tonight, today, and you've worked it, and it's paying off, and I have a feeling America is going to vote for you. I feel you're going to be one of the six.
Thank you.
And I'm not neutered. I am not neutered.
Heidi.
Learn more. I feel like I'm already in a good mood before you even start telling your first joke. Seriously. And I really do hope that you make it to the finale, because I want learn more and laugh more.
Yeah! Sophia, I heard you laughing.
Lerma, you deserve to be here. The people love you. We love you.
Thank you.
It was so much fun. You keep getting better and better every time you're here.
Thank you.
I love it.
Simon, I saw you laughing.
That was so funny. Yeah. And that's what your act is. Honestly, I have to tell you, I really like you as a person. That routine honestly cracked me up. It was so funny and original. I said this Amazing. About somebody else. You have to be in the final. Thank you so deserve it, and I think you will after that.
Learn more. Not only are you my golden buzzer, but you dress amazing. This jacket is fire. Who designed this for you?
I designed it. My sister made it for me. So, yeah, look at this. I need $1 million to win it right now, okay? To pay it back. Please.